21 years ago, on September 11, 2001, 9/11 is the most saddest event in worldwide. I was a baby when I first heard about it, but now I do understand that people was in the building that who died at the 9/11. So everyone, let's pray for everyone that who ended a terrible tragedy back on September 11, 2001. So 9/11, 2001, all the way this year. Don't be heartless. If you look at my Instagram, don't be heartless. Don't say happy, but this is not a happy event. This is really a saddest event ever. Well, back in 2017, we had that stupid 9/11 movie, which honestly, I wish it don't exist in the first place. And this is going to be the longest rant I ever did. And you know what? That rant don't deserve like a longer rant. So, sorry, guys. Anyway, guys, now let's talk about these 9/11 movie came out in 2017, starring Charlie Sheen and Whoopi Goldberg. Honestly, one of the most disrespectful movies I've ever seen in my life, next to Cuties and Cinema 2021. Anyway, so grab your tissues, everyone. Time for the moment of silence. Well, I don't know, but you know what? Screw the moment of silence. Let's talk about this abomination, shall we? Intro, please.
But I know Jesus and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things He gave us, and the greatest is love. And the greatest is love. The greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day?
Hollywood, are you out of your mind? Who in a white mind want to make a movie about the 9/11 like this? This is honestly one of the most disrespectful movies I have ever seen in my life. I have never seen this movie be so terrible, just like the Emoji Movie, Justice League, Monster Truck, and Baywatch. Honestly, I think this movie is even worse than the movie I mentioned. I think this movie is even worse than the Emoji Movie, Joss Whedon, A Bad Mom Christmas, Baywatch, and Monster Truck, which is a Nickelodeon movie, which honestly I really did not like. But that poster, cool poster for the bad movies. Anyway, I don't have any good thing about this movie, not even a good thing about this movie. Anyway, let's get started this rant, shall we? Good morning, everyone. I'm DJ Ruffy, good old neighbor, Nikki, and frozen to another Time to Die fan 2020. And welcome to another amazing video. And today, it's September 11. You know what that means? No, people didn't celebrate anything. This is not a happy celebration. This is really like a sad event. 9/11 is the most terrible tragedy I ever seen because honestly, I was born 2001, and I was honestly I was a baby when I heard about this event. But now, back in 2012, I think, I don't know. I think it's honestly one of the most terrible tragedy I have ever seen in my life, and I feel so bad for people who die at the 9/11, so yeah. Well, this movie didn't do much because this movie is literally like a 9/11 tragedy done bad anyway. Anyway, guys, so today I'm doing a movie review, Flash Rant, one of the worst movies of 2017. I think this movie is even worse than the Emoji Movie. It's had to be that stupid 9/11 movie, which honestly, I wish this movie don't exist in the first place, and honestly, you know why it exists? It's because of money. Well, this movie is a terrible box office number, so thank God for that. And thank God people did not give two crap about this movie. Came out of 2017. Honestly, I think 2017 is the worst year for animation, but 2017 is a great year for movies, but not animation, because I definitely agree with anime, because 2017 is easily one of the worst year for animation next to 2022 and 2013. So yeah. Sorry, guys. I don't want to tell you that the story is, because the story is a stupid story like we see like a million times in every drama movies. Anyway, let's talk about how bad this movie is. This movie's bad. Honestly, this movie is not bad as a good way, like Shark Tale, and Alvin and the Chipmunk, the Road Chip. Those movie I mentioned is hilarious bad. But this movie is not hilarious bad. This movie is B-A-D bad. It's a very bad movie. I cannot believe why this movie exists in the first place. I don't understand why this movie got a trailer. I don't understand why this movie got a release. And I don't understand why this movie got a box office number. This movie don't deserve like those type of treatment. I definitely agree with the one user who hates this movie. It's had to be the goal of the movie guide, honestly. He's really like a trailer reaction, which honestly, his reaction on the 9/11 trailer, it's got to be one of the best videos that he ever did, because that video is hilarious. It's hilarious. And you can see why he hates this movie. So yeah, I don't understand why this movie got a theater release. No, this movie feel like you're going to go to your Walmart and all you see is a 9/11 movie and your $5 movie bargain band. Do I have any good thing about this movie? Not even a good thing about this movie. If I get one good thing about this movie, I will be a very heartless person, because 9/11 is a sad time today. It's a sad time today. Anyway, let's talk about how bad this movie is, shall we? The story for the movie. But this has to be one of the most idiotic story of 2017. I swear to God. The story, it's just no story at all. What type of movie is it? It's like a drama. It's like a horror movie. It's like a documentary. What kind of movie is that? They don't have no genre. This movie is nothing. And the characters, I don't give crap every single character in the movie. And Charlie Sheen. Honestly, I take that back. What I just said about Charlie Sheen from Food Fight, where even he did awful in Food Fight, but Charlie Sheen in 9/11, this has got to be one of his worst performances he ever did. The main reason why I think his performance in this movie is the worst than the Dog Detective, because at least Charlie Sheen tried to be like a dog detective. And this is honestly one of the most hilarious bad performances I ever seen from Charlie Sheen. But his performance in this movie, I cannot believe why he had audacity to be in the 9/11 movies. This is not how 9/11 movies work. The 9/11 is all about people on the elevators and the building crashing down and people died. That's what 9/11 is. 9/11 is not all about doing over the top, making 9/11 movie. And Whoopi Goldberg, I honestly do not like Whoopi Goldberg in this movie. She is the worst thing. She was in Ninja Turtle 2014. Honestly, that is honestly one of the second worst performances I ever seen for Whoopi Goldberg. Honestly, I love Whoopi Goldberg. Whoopi Goldberg is an amazing actress, and she was in she was the voice of a little of a hyena from The Lion King. So yeah, and this is honestly one of her worst performances she ever did, because when I heard her voice, I cannot believe she was talking slow. She's talking slow like this. Be careful, Charlie Sheen. The 9/11 is a terrible tragedy. The building is crashing down. Whoopi Goldberg, can you speak already, woman? Speak already. Can I hear you? I don't have a hearing aid on. I hate this movie. And Charlie Sheen's wife. I did not like Charlie Sheen's wife. Charlie Sheen's wife is stupid. Anyway, and some random people in the elevator. Honestly, I just don't give crap about this movie. And the cinematography, honestly, it makes me sick of my stomach every time I look at the cinematography. What kind of cinematography is this? So, do you remember Enter Fantastic 1 trash and cinematography on the Banana Split movie? Well, I'm trashing the cinematography of this movie, because the cinematography of this movie, this has to be one of the worst cinematography of the 9/11 history, because the cinematography looked absolutely awful. And the frog CGI, honestly, I did not like the frog CGI. Honestly, it make your movie look bad. And the climax, it's just nothing. It's just honestly one of the worst climax of 2017. I cannot believe I have audacity to watch this movie. I should avoid this movie on the plate, but nope, I had to watch it for a movie credit. So yeah. And the ending, honestly, I just don't give two crap about the ending. So overall, 9/11, this is honestly one of the worst movie of 2017. Hollywood, you better be... Hollywood, all I gotta say, you better be ashamed of yourself. I cannot believe why you have audacity to make a movie like this. And I swear to God, if I see this type of movie like this one more time, I am going to Hollywood and rip the who's direct this movie and put him into the paper shredder. This movie is completely wrong. This movie is completely wrong. This movie should be banned. This movie don't deserve to be on Stars. This movie don't deserve to be on digital. This movie don't deserve to be in exist. When I'm in David Zazel, I will get rid of this movie real quick. And I am a Star CEO. I would never ever put this movie on the Stars. I cannot believe why this movie's on Stars. Honestly, if you want a hey guys, if you want to watch a way better movie on Stars, I recommend you go watch Spider-Man No Way Home. Spider-Man No Way Home is a much better Star movie than this piece of crap. Sorry guys. All guys said, this movie is very disrespectful. This movie is disgrace to the 9/11 movies. And on 2017, on the 9/11, people at the 9/11 was rolling from this grave when this movie came out. I definitely agreed with a lot of people. I don't understand why this movie got it. I don't understand why this movie got it on Stars. I don't understand why this movie got digital. I don't understand why this movie got a theater release. And I cannot believe why Hollywood have audacity to release a freaking trailer on YouTube. Honestly, this movie don't deserve to be on trailer. This movie don't deserve to be in the theaters. This is the kind of movie I really want to get this banned real quick. This movie is completely wrong. In my Hicksville, I will ban this movie. I will ban this movie. I might ask Kyle he could ban this movie because honestly, there was no way in a monkey that people will like this movie. I cannot believe why some people like this movie and you think it's a good film. Honestly, I'm a type of person like respecting your, accepting your opinion. But do you think 9/11 movie is a good movie? You're sick. I am very sorry I say this, but you need to wake up. You need to go to your therapist. You need to get a checkup. I don't understand why you want to like this movie. So who in the right mind going to like this movie? There are much better movies than this piece of crap. Like Blade Runner 2049, Coco, and The Greatest Showman. Those three movies I mentioned from 2017 is a way better movie than this piece of crap. I cannot believe why this movie turned 5 years old. Which honestly, thank God I did not celebrate this movie because this movie don't deserve any celebration. This movie is forgetting. After this rant, I will never ever going to speak this movie. I'm not going to make a tune style of this movie. I'm just going to avoid this movie like the play just like I did with Music and Cuties. I am giving 9/11 a 1 out of 10. This is absolutely the worst of the worst. And I am giving this movie a seal of naked garbage. And Hollywood, don't you dare make this type of movies. Man, I am completely mad when I did this rant of this movie. I'm really sorry I took this movie way too seriously, but honestly, I am not ready in Hollywood to give away from this action because honestly, I think it's honestly one of the most toxic movies of 2017. I think this movie even was the Emoji Movie. So I got that was my movie review, Flash Rant, on the 9/11 movie, aka the worst movie of 2017. I think this movie is even worse than Joss Whedon and the Emoji Movie. Honestly, I would have watched those to wipe my butt off than this piece of crap. Anyway, if you like this terrible tragedy video, please hit the subscribe button, turn notification, share with your video for your whole family for all ages, and stay tuned for my puppy review stuff, Funniest Moment Part 3, which honestly, it's going to be a warning, it's going to be a mature audience, so kids, don't watch my next video, because it's going to be a mature audience, it's going to have a lot of cussing, so yeah, I just want to treat you like a parent, so parent, if you're watching this, so just don't wait your kids, watch my next video, because my next video it's going to be a mature audience because all of my video is has to be for kids. Honestly, I am turning 21 years old. I am 20, not a 5-year-old child. So, yeah. Sorry, guys. If you like this terrible Charlie Sheen video, please hit the subscribe button, turn notification, and share with your family for always. And stay tuned for my. I don't know what medic. honestly, I don't know what my next video is going to be, but we're going to end right here. So yeah, tonight, after breakfast, I'm just going to watch season 3 of Cobra Kai, because honestly, season 2 is honestly one of my favorite seasons of Cobra Kai so far, because I haven't seen season 5 yet, but I need to watch it before I watch season 5. Sorry, that was terrible. So if you don't like it, you could just skip it. Sorry guys, subscribe, comment, show this video with your family. And Frozen, I swear to God, do not watch this movie. Avoid it like the plague. You have much better movie back in years ago. The Great Showman is way better 2017 movie than this piece of crap. The Great Showman, best movie of 2017. But this movie is honestly one of the worst movies of 2017. I don't understand why some Hollywood have audacity to make a movie like this. You know what? If I make a 9/11 movie, I will make a very dark and tragedy animated movie about 9/11. Feature all the character, which I know, which are best actress, actor I ever seen. Sorry guys, I'm just gonna end right here. I see you next time, and so long, and peace YouTube. Let's pray, people that who die at the 9/11. Have a good day, everyone, and I see you guys next time.